Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to Continuing the Conversation, live from the APWA Congress Trade Show floor at the Expo Experience. And I'm sad to say it's the last conversation of the 2011 APWA International Public Works Congress and Exposition. But you could say we saved the best for last.
Let's hope.
Jumping in. So we're going to be chatting with Greg Steinberg, who's a sports psychologist and professor of human performance. Now, Greg is tomorrow's closing general session speaker. So this is unique. You get some alone time with him, some one-on-one time to ask him questions, pick his brain, get your voice heard. For everyone here in Denver, this truly is a conversation, okay? So when you have a question, you want to chat, go ahead and raise your hand. We'll bring the microphone over to you so everyone can hear. Or if you want to do it the new way, go ahead and use Twitter via the hashtag APWA Expo. For everyone at home, this is your last chance. Using Twitter via the hashtag APWA Expo or via that Q&A button in the lower left-hand corner of your screen. So, Dr. Greg, welcome.
Thanks for having me.
All right. I got to ask the obvious question. You're a sports psychologist. This is the public works industry. Why are you here?
Well, that is a million-dollar question that everybody asks me. And I would say it doesn't matter if it's public works. It doesn't matter if it's finance. It doesn't matter if it's tennis. It doesn't matter if it's golf. The principles to performance, successful performance, should all be the same. And if they're true principles, they go across all venues. And so tomorrow, I'm going to give some true principles that apply to public works as they also apply to professional athletes, as they apply to business people. And again, they should be the same, and so I'm just giving true principles.
All right. When he references tomorrow, what he means is that closing general session, which everyone here in Denver can see at 11 a.m. Mountain Time, and everyone at home can see as well at 11 a.m. Mountain Time. And it is called Full Throttle, How to Supercharge Your Energy and Performance at Work. And let's face it, times are tough. So we really do need to be supercharged in our energy and our performance at work and at home. So give us a little preview. What are you going to chat about?
Well, the talk tomorrow is called Full Throttle. And what I do is I explain how to find your best state, which I call your prime emotional state. Okay. And the idea is what I've discovered is there's a from my work with professional athletes, business people, CEOs, entrepreneurs, I've discovered this triad of greatness. And the triad of greatness is 3 points. The first point is you have to be aware of your prime emotional state. That's when you're at your best. Okay. And you have to know the emotions that contribute to this best state. 2 is you have to emotionally prepare yourself to make this prime emotional state your best. Because the third point is the key, and that is we go to our habits under pressure. So if you made your prime emotional state your habit, you're going to fall back into greatness when pressure comes. We hear this term with elite athletes that they've raised their game. So yeah. If you watch Tom Brady of the Patriots or Peyton Manning of the Colts, and under pressure you see they get better, and you think, God, they raised their game. They don't raise their game. They actually fall back into greatness. They return to greatness because they've made their prime emotional state their habit. And that's what I'm going to show everybody tomorrow how to do, is how to make greatness your habit so that you return to greatness when it really counts and so that you will be your best when it really counts.
So how did you figure all of this out?
Years and years of work. Well, I've worked with some of the best NBA players, NFL players, PGA. And as I mentioned, you start looking for similarities across performance settings. And these are what I consider true principles of successful performance, is this triad of greatness, this prime emotional state, and that they make it their habit.
All right, so what kind of questions do we have for Dr. Greg about increasing your performance or falling back on your emotional state? Any comments? Does this sound like malarkey?
I hope not.
I mean, I think it sounds really interesting because, let's face it, people who are extremely successful have to share some commonalities. And you have studied successful people in all sorts of different career paths, and you've seen some common trends. You've you know, put together this triad of greatness. What are some, without giving away what you're chatting with tomorrow, but what can you tell us about this now? Give us a little tip.
The first step is emotional awareness.
Okay.
And so you have to be aware of your emotions. And so what I ask everybody is, recall a time when you're at your best. So think about you.
Actually, let's do this. Everybody, take a minute. Recall
no, we're
going
to do this with you. Okay.
No.
So think about a time when you're at your best.
Okay.
So tell us a time when you're at your best.
Right now,
like
chatting
just,
with you.
You were just nailing it. You know,
right
a time
now, chatting with you.
You were at your peak. Okay. So what emotions contribute to that? Like, what's your confidence level? What's your intensity level? What's your enjoyment level? What's your nervousness level? Are you thinking or just reacting? So those are like levels of this, what I call prime emotional state.
Okay.
So what, if you could, in a nutshell, how does it feel when you're at your best?
How does it feel when I'm at my best? Thanks a lot, guys. Look what's happening. All right.
You do have the mic.
Well, I know. But according to John and Cass over here, when I'm at my best, I smile a lot. And I think I laugh, and
so enjoyment
it's
and
enjoyment
fun,
and fun,
engaging.
But on the same token, I think there's also this sense of calmness,
okay,
like no stress.
Okay. So those are the emotions that you have when you're at your best. And I would guarantee you, whether you're doing TV, whether you're in front of a group, whether you're talking to a client or with your friends, those are the emotions that contribute to your best state across all venues. And so this prime emotional state is not just when you're on TV, it's across all venues. It's what we call a personality dimension. And the next step I would say is, if you could characterize a word or two words, and what I call buzzwords, because buzz, you know, when you're at your best, you feel this buzz, this internal great feeling.
Yeah, right?
When you're at your best, give me a buzzword that it feels like. I'm putting you on the spot.
You totally, it's like a natural high. I always say I never have to jump out of an airplane because I have such an adrenaline rush,
okay,
from, you know, being in conversations with people that I've never spoken,
okay,
with before.
So your buzzwords could be maybe feel the rush.
Yeah.
And then you put those buzzwords on your computer, on your nightstand, on your refrigerator, on your steering wheel. And every time you see feel the rush, it's that great feeling that you have on TV. And then it becomes a habit because you're bringing up those feelings time and time and time again. And so that becomes your habit. And so now when you are maybe a little tired, like maybe today, I don't know, because I don't know how long you've been working, or it's been a long day and you don't feel like you have it, you think, feel the rush, and you feel those feelings, and it's going to get you pumped up. And that's where you gain that great energy and that the great feelings because you've made that your habit. You've emotionally prepared yourself previous to the experience, and when you need it, you can call upon it and raise your game when you need to.
So we need to call upon it, we need to raise our game, and I hope when I was doing that for me, you were all thinking about your own specific interests, yes? And
that's situations. What we're going to do tomorrow. They have to contribute
ha,
tomorrow.
Ha, ha, ha. You're on the spot tomorrow. I'm done. All right, so everyone at home, hopefully you were going along with that exercise, but remember, you get to do it again tomorrow in Dr. Gregg's closing general session. But what kind of questions do you have for him right now? This is one-on-one dedicated time. Go ahead and tweet to hashtag APWAExpo or hit that Q&A button in the lower left-hand corner of the screen, and thank you to somebody for doing just that.
I do have a question. Obviously, the economy has affected a lot of us. It's affected a lot of people, particularly in public works. Do you work with non-professional athletes? Do you work with folks who are suffering these financial impacts? And kind of what tips do you have for them to control their emotions and their stress?
Well, again, these principles or truisms will go across all settings. And it's not just about being a professional athlete.
Right.
It's about public works. It's about all business sectors. And I would say another way that this could work is you would not only think about your best state, but you'd also think about when you choke and when you're at your worst. And the idea here is, if you know when you're at your worst, what causes the stressors and the pressures, and you know what causes you to feel great, you know what path to avoid and what path to take. And so emotional awareness is the first and primary step to finding your greatness.
So this truly can be applied to everybody in every situation, no matter what their job, no matter, I mean, anything. I mean, this just because you maybe developed this as a result of working with sports professionals, this can be applied anywhere.
Well, yes, I developed it working with professionals, but I also developed it working with business executives, entrepreneurs. So it's not just primarily, but because if you look at, and I do work with a lot of athletes, but if you look at sport, it's such a great venue to understand performance because there's time constraints, there's pressure, there's an outcome. And so if you look at what great athletes do, you can understand what success principles are, but it's not about sport, it's about performance.
Time constraints, we all have those in public work.
Pressure.
Yes, lots of pressure.
Outcomes.
Lots of outcomes.
All
we're
the principles
for.
Are the same as public works.
So what kind of questions do we have? How can we help you apply this to your specific situation? Everyone at home, let us know. Everyone here, go ahead and raise your hand. He already put me on the spot. So, hey, have my back and put him on the spot. How about that? Tom's got something. Here's the microphone.
Thank you. From the perspective of a weekend athlete, how do you apply your principles to the issue of just once a week you're out doing what you like to do and what you want to do well?
Well, that's an interesting question because I think when you're talking about weekend athletes, you have to keep it in perspective. And you have to be realistic about how well you can play. Now, I tell my friends, if I play golf with them, they're having a bad day, I always say, the good news is you don't play golf for a living. The bad news is you don't play golf for a living. And that's the perspective I try to give people. And so the idea here is when we have these high expectations to play great, it puts so much pressure on us and it ruins our day. When you keep expectations realistic, then you have the right emotions. So the idea about being successful, whether it's enjoying it, whether it's performing well, it's really about mastering your emotions. Having the right thoughts to master your emotions and having the right expectations will create the right emotions, which is have fun, enjoy it because you have the right expectations.
But oftentimes expectations are placed onto us by our boss, by a public official, by the community. So it's one thing to manage your own expectations, but how do we manage expectations that are placed on us by external sources?
Well, again, I think you have to, I think a great way to manage your emotions would be, yes, these expectations are placed on us, but be realistic and say, this is the best I can be. This, I can only be so good, and I'm going to try to be the best I can be. And that allows us to manage our emotions because we're in control of the best we can be. We can't control other people's expectations. We can never control their feelings towards us. We can only control our feelings towards ourselves. And if we're believing we're doing the best we can be, then we manage our emotions and ultimately we're in the right space or emotional state that we want.
So are you saying if we believe in ourselves, we will enable others to believe in us?
Well, that's a big point, and that relates to confidence. But I'm really saying if your goal is to be the best you could be in any setting, public works, weekend, golf, then you're in control of those emotions. You're in control of those expectations, and thus you're going to keep everything realistic.
Keeping it realistic, keeping it real. Absolutely. Do we have any more questions? We've only got about a couple more minutes left here with Dr. Greg. He'll get you back tomorrow. Yes, we do have a question.
We do have a comment. Emily, our virtual audience really appreciated you saying, yes, in public works, we're doing more with less. And following up with the financial question is, and I'm going to speak here for Lawrence because I've been his voice today.
Thank you, Lawrence.
Yes. But what happens when what you get your buzz from, Emily gets her buzz from having a conversation with a stranger, she said. So what happens if what you get your buzz from is not what you're doing for a living or your financial constraints have forced you into a situation where you're not able to work where you get your buzz?
Great question, Lawrence.
So this person is, let's say, getting their buzz from rock climbing and they don't get their buzz from being a teacher. That's the question I hear.
Or let's say they get their buzz from working for the city. But the pay for the private sector is better.
Okay. Well, I would say that where you get your buzz is a really important factor. And you have to be aware of what's causing that buzz. and we talk about strengths and we talk about weaknesses. I'm always a fan of focusing on your strengths. And if this person gets their buzz because they're creative, innovative, and they're independent, then they got to figure out how they can apply those buzz feelings using their strengths in other avenues. And so that's the secret. Where do you get that buzz? Be emotionally aware and figure out how you can plant that in every part of your life. Because if you do that, then you're going to be successful not only at work but in life.
What do we think? Yeah? No? Ooh. There's discourse among the crowd. Some people are saying yes, some people are saying maybe not so much. But I mean, this is what happens in life, right? We always have to overcome objectives. We always have to overcome people who don't agree with what we believe. So how do we all work together? To sum it all up, how do we all fall back on our greatness?
Can't we all get along?
Yes. How?
Well, I mean, in terms, I think if we look at what makes a great team, it's not necessarily social, what we call social cohesion, which is getting along. It's that the team is working towards the same goal, which we call task cohesion.
Okay.
And so the idea is, if you're saying if we all get along, that we're all motivated towards the same goal, and whether we have niches is okay. So if I was a team leader, I would make sure we're all on the same boat working towards the same goal. That's how we all get along. And that's what the best teams do. They don't necessarily go out to pizza and hang out. They're all motivated to win the championship, and that goal is pounded over and over again. And we know this in sports psychology. Task cohesion is what binds the teams together, not this clique and getting along with your other teammates.
So you don't necessarily have to like your neighbor. You don't necessarily have to agree with everything that they
have. You don't have to
like
the TV commentator that you're taking the interview from. No, I'm just kidding.
I challenged them, and this is what I get. So you don't have to like your neighbor or your deskmate. You don't have to agree with everything that everyone else says in your department or your municipality. But as long as we all work together towards the common goal of improving the public works industry, improving life for our municipalities, kind of came up the other day that public works makes life work. So we just need to all work together and take the industry into the future. Dr. Greg, thank you so very much for spending some time with us.
Thanks for having me.
We look forward to seeing you tomorrow at 11 a.m. He's doing the closing general session. It's entitled Full Throttle, How to Supercharge Your Energy and Performance at Work. And just be prepared, you're going to be put on the spot as well. So thanks for letting me put you on the spot. And for everyone here in Denver, thank you so very much for coming to the Expo Experience and continuing the conversation with us. And for everyone at home, thank you for spending the last 2 days with us. We really appreciate you coming. We hope we've given you a taste of what you can experience next year in Anaheim. Save the dates. It's August 26th through 29th. We appreciate your viewing. We appreciate your participation. I want to say a special thank you for Lawrence, because I feel like you were with us every single conversation, and I hope that your voice was heard. If you want to check out some more, or if you want to share any of these conversations with your friends, we will be sending you an email next week with a link to the archive. So please, see what you missed, go back and review what you want to see again, and share them with your friends. And don't forget, you too can see Dr. Greg tomorrow morning from 11 a.m. until 12:15 p.m. Mountain Time as he does the closing general session entitled Full Throttle, How to Supercharge Your Energy and Performance at Work. So, one last time, thank you so very much for joining us here at Continuing the Conversation, live from the 2011 APWA International Public Works Congress and Exposition, live from the Expo Experience. See you next year in Anaheim. Bye-bye.